What's up, Hoopers? This is Coach Alex from Think Pro Basketball, and in today's video, we are going to go over how to become a better playmaker, the keys to dropping dimes. Let's get started. You'll see me these salmon and wild whiz. I just laugh at them when they wear vests because it's head shots on sight. I don't do beef, I just lay it to rest. I'm so hungry, my voice sound malicious. On my journey, I'm chasing my riches. I got so many reasons that I gotta make it, so I wake up and I go get. I move like I'm the mob in my all black. You ain't down with my squad, you can fall back. If you never seen greatness, then you about to witness, and you gonna know what you should call that. All right, guys, well, like I said, I'm gonna give you a couple different keys to become a better playmaker. And the first thing that we're going to start with is your ball handling. Can you break down a defense? Can you get into the gaps of the defense? Can you make the right plays off of that? If you have your ball handling skills down, that's going to open up a lot of opportunities and create opportunities, number one, for yourself to make plays, and number two, to make plays for those around you, your teammates, getting them involved. But you have to be able to break down a defense. If you're the type of guy that just stands out here, makes a pass, and can't put the ball on the floor, then you're going to have a little bit more trouble picking apart a defense, dropping dimes, and making plays. So make sure that your ball handling skills are on point, because that's going to create so much more for yourself. And I think that's one of the biggest keys in becoming a better playmaker, is being able to get into the defense, get into the teeth of the defense, break them down. So getting into these gaps, boom, making plays, dropping it off to your big, throwing a lob, kicking out to three-point shooters. But if you can do that, it makes life easier, not only for yourself, but for others around you. And you're the one that gets the credit for the assist. So the first thing, make sure your ball handling is on point. That's step one of becoming a better playmaker. You should call that. Every song that I've been on is a hit like a ball back. I took some losses, but I got them all back. Been at the bottom. All right, next, we're talking about dropping dimes, obviously, and becoming a great playmaker. So you have to be able to pass on time. Passing on time is important. An example of that is if your offensive player cuts back door. Boom, so if I'm dribbling at you and you cut back door, but I wait too long, like I wait for you to get all the way down to the block, I've thrown it too late. Why? Because now you have to catch it, collect yourself, and by that time, help defense can come over. But if I dribble at you, you back cut, and I throw it right after that first step, that first initial plant, right when you catch it, you're in stride to maybe take a dribble, get to the basket, or catch it and even use a pull-up jump shot. So passing on time is so important. If I'm running the break, I gotta be able to give it to you right on time, for I know all you have to do is catch, get your feet set, and knock that shot down. You see a lot of great passers, a lot of great playmakers in the NBA, Chris Paul, Russell Westbrook, Kyrie Irving, guys of that nature who are wonderful playmakers for their team, LeBron James even, who can, number one, see the court like no other, and pass on time. They know how to set up their teammates and put them in the right positions to score. If you can do that, that's gonna help you, it's gonna help your teammates, and it's gonna set them up for better shots and better plays. So passing on time is step number two to becoming a better playmaker. Been at the bottom and I'm never going back. I'm fully focused and I'm on track. I'm tired of waiting, I'm running out of patience. All right, the third key I'm going to talk about is passing on target. All right, so we just talked about passing on time, but passing on target. Now, I played with a lot of different players, and a lot of them were different with the way they wanted the, or where they wanted the basketball. I had some teammates who liked the ball, boom, right in their shooting pocket. I had teammates that liked the ball low because it allowed them to get a rhythm to catch it here and then to bring the ball up in rhythm into their shot. So passing on target, knowing where your teammates want the ball, is very important. So again, if you're going on a backdoor cut, I most likely want to put that ball right in front so you could catch it in stride to get your layup. If I'm passing to a shooter, so if I'm here and I'm passing to a shooter and I know they want that ball right in their shooting pocket, I got to make sure I hit them here so I make it easier on them. Because if you pass it to somebody low who doesn't like it low, then they got to do all this. They might even have to dribble, and there goes your assist. Passing on target is important. Know what type of passes your teammates want, how they want it. You know, do they like catching the ball on the left side so they can swing it over to their right? Do they like it on the right side to swing it to their left? Like it low, do they like it high? Know who you're passing to on target so you can make it easier, again, for yourself and for them. That's the key to being a playmaker. Make life easier on yourself, make life easier for your teammates, and if you do, they'll love you for it. And you get the credit. Again, I've already said that you get the credit for the assist, but knowing to pass on target is very important. Work on it. There's simple drills to do that. Put some tape on a wall, work on hitting that tape on the wall over and over, so you're working on your accuracy of the pass, bounce passes, overhead passes, chest pass, behind the back, all different ways, but that's a simple drill to use. But passing on target is key number three. Patience, I'm about to make my move right now. I'm about to make my move right now. I'm tired of waiting. Now, one of the biggest keys I learned as a point guard in playing this position, becoming a playmaker, was knowing who I was passing to, right? So if I'm running the transition, do I want to throw the ball to my center at half court to make him dribble the basketball? Or if I'm running, down the lane and I'm throwing a pass to a guard who's underneath the hoop, knowing they're not going to be affected. I have to know who and when I'm passing to, but most importantly, know who you're passing to. Don't give the ball to your big man too early. Don't give the ball to your shooter too late, right? You have to know what kind of player you're giving. Am I giving it to a shooter, or am I giving it to a guy who needs to catch it and get to the basket? Am I giving it to my big man in the right position where he doesn't have to put the ball on the floor because his dribble is a little shaky? Am I throwing it to an athlete who can go get the ball at the rim? Luckily, I got to play with a lot of guys who can go get the ball above the basket, so I can throw lobs, I can throw bounce passes, chest passes, all different types of things, but you have to know the type of player you're passing it to. So that comes with you figuring out what type of teammates you have. Know who your shooters are. Know who your guys that are slashing to the basket and willing to put the ball on the floor to get there. Know what kind of big man you have. Do you have a big man that can stretch the court, or do you have a big that needs to run all the way down to the basket and where to give him that? Okay? So you have to know who you're passing to. That's key number four. That's it. That's the last one I have for you today, and become a better player or playmaker and a better dime dropper. I'm running out of patience. I'm about to make my move right now. All right, Hoopers, well, that's it for today's video. I hope you learned a little bit about how to become a better playmaker and the keys to dropping dimes. Now, it's important that you think about everything that I've talked about in today's video so you can do that and apply it to your game. Now, you don't have to be a point guard to drop dimes. You could be a big man as well, or a wing player. All right, now, if you liked today's video, do me a favor, click the like button, leave a comment, let us know what you think, and anything that you would like to see in the future, because we got your back, we'll cover you, we'll get that video done. But most importantly, you click that subscribe button and join Think Pro Basketball if you haven't already, and check out all the great, awesome content that we have to offer. Now, it's your turn to get out there, hit the gym, hit the court, playing some pickup games, work on your passing, pass on time, pass on target, and know who you're passing to, and become a great playmaker. And remember to always keep hooping. See you soon. I'm tired of waiting. I'm running out of patience. I'm about to make my move right now.